Good morning, everyone. Today's drawing is a freebie that was off of Facebook. It's by Bennett Klein. He's got a whole group of people over there, and I'm not really going to do a review on the book today. There's a gold that I did with some browns and yellows, and I will be showing how I do gold without using gold pencils. But anyway, I got this book from over there. Is available on Amazon, but what I want to show you is how I'm doing silver. Now, in this picture, I've used no silver at all. I'm using my Prismacolors. I went in and I pulled, okay, these are the cool grays. There's a difference in the cool, the warm, and the French. I'm not going to go into all that except to say that the cool grays I find better for silver. And this is my first try at silver, so bear with me, I'm learning with you. This is a 90%, this is the 70%, and you should be able to use any brand and be able to do this. Then this is the 60%, 30%, 10%, and my white. No colorless blender, as you know by now if you've been following me very long. I don't very often use a colorless blender. I just I don't see the need for it. If it helps you, go for it. Now, when you have a page that already has the lines where the darker is, makes it a lot easier. I'm gonna come in here very light touch, barely touching at all. And I'm laying down my darker color. Now, what I do on one side, I like to mirror on the other side if it's a piece that is the same on both sides. Just because if I go ahead and mirror it now, then it makes it easier for me later. And see, like this, it's down under there. It's not really showing. So I'm just going to put some in there. But yeah, I find if I mirror as I go, it makes the whole thing look more balanced when I go back and start blending. So what I'm doing is I'm stopping to look, what did I do over there? What am I going to do over here? And let's just, let's go ahead and do this rounded part too. And see, this is darker. This is darker. Here, here. In fact, let's just stop at this little flip. So then I go back over to the other side and we do the flip. Let's go ahead and do that because that's above it. Yeah, you just have to really watch what you're doing so that you keep it as even as possible for what you're doing, if that made any sense. And see, like that line there is not showing, but over here it is. So I'll go ahead and do that. Then I'm going to come back with my next color. And I'm going to come right beside everything I just did. Just very lightly. Ever so lightly, just getting that color in. And even as I start blending, I may find a spot that needs to be darkened a little. And if I do, then I'll go back and darken it a little. No big deal. Because I've got my pencils out, I know exactly which ones I'm using. Not too difficult at all. Okay, so I just got a little color on. Alright, I think I got everything. Now we'll go to the next slider. And we're just going to keep doing this. I'm not really blending anything right now. I'm just getting the color on. And I'm just putting a little on because we need to get this reflectiveness, like here. We need to leave a big area that does not have color. Okay? So we've got to keep our colors real tightly together right now. Okay, come on. come over to this side, same thing. I don't know if I've been doing that. We'll go ahead and do it. It is easier if you only do certain sections at a time. Okay, I might have bit off a little more than I should have on this, but anyway, we'll see. You'll know when I start blending if I bit off too much. Now, what I like to do is this one has left a lot in the lightest color, so I'm going to try not to use too much of the number 10 and save that for around here. So I like to go ahead and use my, I'm on number 30 now, and I'll just go ahead and come on across, and I'm just lightly putting it everywhere, just lightly. And again, I'm just learning to do all this, so I am by no means an expert on it. But I'm going to lightly coat everything with this color. And I did not bring my eraser in with me. Okay. On the last part, now this is going to come over to here and then end. So I do need to make sure. Yeah, I did it on that side. Did I? Yeah, this isn't quite evenly drawn either. So, but that's okay. A lot of your pictures are not. Again, if I hold my pencils in color order, it makes it easier for me to grab them when I need them. Okay, the first time through, I really ended up with not enough area that was light, like this, and this, and this. So I had to go back and erase. And to be honest with you, I grabbed a pink school eraser, and it took up just enough that I was okay. Because these are the Prismacolor Premier wax base. They do not just normally erase very well. But it did enough that I was able to do what I wanted to show you. Okay, so now that's all in. Alright, so next then I'm going to move to these two colors and we're going to start doing some blending. But I am going to go grab that eraser, so y'all hang on. Don't go anywhere. Okay, so you didn't miss me a bit. Yeah, just one of these pink school erasers from Walmart or CVS or Walgreens or any of those. You can get them for like 50 cents. And it did allow me to erase, again, just enough that I was able to accomplish what I wanted. So now you see how these all look darker. And these, you can barely tell I even did anything. But if I hold it up here, you can see some of the color that's in there. Again, I kept it very light. Now I'm going to come in with this pencil, and I'm going to start doing all these light areas, the ones that are just right there. Now see, it's picking up that darker color I put and spreading it around some. Okay, so I'm going to get these done. Now this is a big area and we really want white there because that's what's going to be that shine. Okay, and then I'll bring this on in. Okay, and that's what I did here. So we're going to pop over here because we know there's another one. Let's go ahead and get that white done in there. And then I'm back to my 10%. Cool gray and coming around. The 10% is just like barely there, but it's enough that it's not white paper. And see, I guess you would say I'm using this 10% as a colorless blender, but I'm still adding more color by using it instead of just moving around the color that's there. I don't like to just move around what's there. I like to add more color to it. Okay, so I think we got all those. Now we're going to come in and start blending. I'm going to start with my white and put white in those big areas because that's what we really need to pop and shine. Okay, we need this for it to be shiny. And I do have a little bit of that other gray down under there. So I am blending this with that so that it's not just stark white. But if I don't get enough white in these areas, then I can come back with that eraser. So I'm just coming into these areas that look like they're the center spot and just making sure that there's white. Okay, and again, I am no expert on this. This is still my first piece to even experiment with using these grays instead of using a silver pencil. But I wanted to have lights and darks, and you just can't do that with one silver pencil. All right, now I'm going to come in with that 10% again, and we're going to start doing some blending. We're going to start up here where we put the dark first and just blend it out. And then as we get to that white area, we're going to be even lighter. But just blending. Kind of using this as our colorless blender. Just blending in my circles. Just going to blend everything with this pencil. See how that almost looks reflective right in there now? So you can't see a lot of the color at first, but then once you start blending, that color will start popping through. Because see, we kept it real close so that it would move around a little bit while we added more color. Just really trying to blend this out. Now, do you see how this goes underneath, but it's not shaded? So what I would do is just come back in with my 70%. Just add a little bit right there. Okay, yeah, the lines weren't there on this side. If you go over and look on this side, let's see, where is that piece? It's down here. It's not here either, so I'm just going to go ahead and add that now. That way, when I go over there and start blending, it'll already be there. What I do on one side, I try to do on the other. Okay, now all of this is a lot lighter than this. Not sure. Maybe I applied the colors a little differently. And it could be that I used one shade darker to blend with instead of the one I'm using now. But because I am also just learning, I'm just trying different things. And again, this is my Prismacolors. You could do this with any pencil that has several grays to it. Make sure the grays are, I guess you would call these almost a blue tinted or blue based gray. Okay, I think that's good now. So yeah, so it just, there's a little difference to it, and I'm sure it probably is that I used a different, let's see, this one's the lighter one. So if I come up in here, I blend a little with this. Yeah, see, then it's getting just a little darker. but I don't want to deepen it up too much. I want to leave that reflective area right there. So I can come up to that, just don't go into it. Same thing here, I want to leave that, I want to leave that. So just kind of play with it and touch it up and go back and forth where you feel you need to. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and keep this one out in case we do that on this side too. So I'm going to come into the dark areas, do my ovals as I move over. I like to do ovals just because it's a fluid motion that is going to keep it more evenly blended for the way I color. I know a lot of people that just do straight lines and stuff, and if that works for you, then go for it. For me, not so much, unless I'm in a long, narrow area like that. For the most part, I like to keep an oval going just because it's got the smooth edge. And see, going in here, blending all those different grays, and then that one where I added just a bit, so that it would look tucked under. You can see how that gray is moving around. I hope you can see that on camera. It's blending really well for me here. But again, because it is a lighter color, you may not be able to see it quite as much where you're at. Okay, so now I'm going to go back with this one and go ahead and mirror what we did over there. We just came and added a little bit to deepen it up some. But I had to make sure that I had those light areas. So keeping light, you know. Certain areas that you just need to keep light so it looks reflective. If it's not looking reflective, you're going to miss that whole point that we're trying to get with it being silver. And see, all of this is lighter than this because of where it's at. See, these are curled and looped where these are more flat. So these would be lighter. Okay. Now, what I did with the eraser, let's say you have no reflective light in here. Can you see how if I just hit it with the eraser, how it's giving me some extra white or reflective light? It's not taking off a lot of color. Excuse me. I don't want a lot of color taken off. I still want some color on there. I'm just trying to give myself a little bit more light. And if I come in with my electric, my battery operated eraser, it would take even more off, but I'm not sure I want that much taken off. Okay, then I can come in with the white, and if I want to, I can still put more of that white back in those areas. You see how it's looking a little more reflective? Just anywhere where it's light and you want it to be lighter, that's where you're going to put in some of that white. Paper only has so much tooth, and once you've filled it up, you can't add any more. So that's why I went back in and erased some. Okay, we have a little bit of time left. So I'm going to come in and I'm going to work on a section. Let's do just this loop on both sides so we don't get tangled up and lost on where we are. Now I forgot to blend that. Okay, so this is a little dark. This is a little dark. This is basically dark. This is darker. Okay, so we're only going to there. All right, so we did this, this, there's some here. This is basically dark. And then we did the loop here. Okay. Let's go to the next darker, which is our 70%. When you're doing this, you don't have to grab every percent. You can skip like every other one. Just don't skip more than one, because it's going to be such a large jump in color change that you will have a difficult time, or a more difficult time, in blending those. Okay, so you can skip every other, but just don't skip too much. What I'm doing is comparing over here to see how far up I blended. Okay, and my hand is just showing me how far down I'm coming on the project. Okay, the next one that I am using is a 50 or 60. I think it's a 50. It's kind of hard to read that sometimes. They are just so shiny. So then I'm going to come in here. I'm going to put a little right there. Why? I don't know. Just did. Not a real rhyme or reason. I think just because it's coming out of that turn, I don't want it stark white. And see, this is, I'm almost losing that, and I want it to be reflective. So I've got to be careful on how much I put on there. And this can come up just a little bit more. All right, so then our next shade is our 30%. And with this one, I'm just going to go ahead and blend that. I come in a little more. See, it's already almost touching. So I really want to be careful there. And that's coming out of there. So that would really, because that's over the top, that would really be shaded too. So let's just go ahead and do all that. Okay, being real careful here, it's going to be touching. I see us having to come back with the eraser on that. Okay, so then let's go to the lightest one, which is our 10. You know what? Let's go ahead and put some white in there real quick and see if we can save that and not have to erase. Just build that white up where that reflection's going to be, and right there. Okay. So that middle area, so if you were doing like a silver apple or a ball or something that's silver, you would look for where that reflective light is and you would hit that with the white. You know what I'm saying? Okay, now I'm going to come in and just really start blending. And I didn't do this before, so let's do that on both sides. Let's just get it blended. Okay, now let's blend these. Coming all the way down through there. Let's do this. Get that all blended. Okay, over to this side. Those darks blended. This is our color that we did that with, so that little inner piece. Come down through here and do this. All of this was dark, but let's just make sure it's well blended. To me, it's not as easy to do silver as it is gold. And I am going to come in with this eraser and just go ahead and lift some of this color. You see how that shine is there? Do you see the difference in this one and this one? Okay, so now I'm going to come in here. and I went the direction that the piece is flowing. And I'm really going at it, okay? I've really put some pressure into that. I'm going to come in with the white now and blend everything in that section right close to where that is so that we get that good shine. I've been told from what I've been reading and questioning on other sites that the white is really what's going to make it pop and look reflective. So if I wanted this even more reflective, I could go ahead and come in here and really just remove more of that. What I do on one side, I'm going to do on the other. Then come back in with the white and really blend. So can you see how that looks even more reflective now? So that tells me that really worked well. So that's what I'm going to have to do as I'm going through. Anything that's not as reflective as I want it, I'm just really going to get in there, remove some of that color, and then come back in with the white and really blend that out. Blending all the way down in there. Yeah, my pencil stuff, or my eraser stuff got in there. You're going to see when I do the golden a little bit, how much easier it is. And I think it's because browns and yellows are just easier to work with than these. But anyway, that's how I am doing silver. And play with it, experiment. I don't know if there's a right or wrong way. I tried it once, putting down the white first, and that works too. Here, I'll do this little section right here on both sides. If it times out, I'm sorry. So I'm doing those two sections, then get the next darker. Then get the next darker. Then the next one. And just keep going. And you can see how that is more reflective. Okay, the white is a whole lot more white. Yeah, and just keep adding the color. Now I'm not going to add the darkest on these two right here because we're out of space, but I will add them up here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back with the white and blend everything. And we'll see how that does. Again, it's just learning as you go. We're going to have to play with it. See, that looks even a little bit more reflective than that. So maybe that's our trick. Okay, maybe we need to start with the white. And then I'm actually going to go into my other one that I was using as a blender and do some of that too. And if it gets where there's not enough dark in there, come back with one of your darks. Add it. Make sure you're adding it evenly, so your piece doesn't look cattywampus. Then come back and blend it a little bit. Okay? So maybe you'll do a better job if you do it that way. You know, starting with your whites and working to the darks. Okay? So anyway, that's my take on silver. We will get to gold in just a little bit. All right? Okay, thanks for watching.